CIET NCERT presents curriculum based series Dhwani Shala. So let's join in Dhwani Shala class 7.
Hello dear students, I'm your friend Premlata. Nice to have you here. Hope you're happy, healthy and fine. Today we'll learn about chapter 1 integers of class 7th NCERT maths. Before I start, I presume that you all must be familiar with the concept of natural numbers, which are also known as counting numbers. For example, when I have to count the number of rooms in my house, I start counting from 1 and then continue on counting. I found that there were 5 rooms in my house. So, we see that natural numbers are the counting numbers that begin from 1. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. Now let's talk about the whole numbers. Where does the concept of whole numbers come from? For example, I have to count the number of monkeys that live in my house. Now, monkeys do not live in my house. I can't start counting from 1. So here comes the concept of nothing. So we depict nothing as 0 in mathematics. There are 0 monkeys in my house. Arrival of 0 completed the family of natural numbers and they became whole numbers. So now these natural numbers with 0 are called whole numbers. That is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on. Now let's add some feelings to our numbers. In mathematics, we represent happy things or feelings or profits as positive numbers. And we represent sad feelings or losses as negative numbers. Let's take an example. I got 5 toffees, so I'll be happy. I will represent it as plus 5. And if I lost 3 rupees, then I will be sad. So I'll represent it as minus 3. Plus sign will show my happiness and I write them as positive numbers. Minus sign will show my sadness and I will write them as negative numbers. This combination of positive numbers and negative numbers is referred to as integers. Now, you all must be aware of a number line. A number line is a straight line with numbers placed at equal intervals along its length. A number line has 0 in the middle. It can be extended infinitely in either direction. It is usually represented horizontally. Sometimes you must have seen it in a vertical or standing position also. But most of the time, it is represented horizontally. By horizontally, I mean flat or sleeping line. The numbers on the number line increases as one moves towards right and they decrease when we move towards left. A number line can also be used to represent both positive and negative integers. Writing numbers on a number line make comparing numbers easier. Numbers on the left are smaller than the numbers on the right of the number line. Now tell me, on which side of 0 the number 4 lies on number line? Left or right? Think. I'll give you few seconds for that. Yes, on the right side of zero. Now tell me, on which side of zero the number minus 2 lies on? Left or right of zero? Think. Yes, on the left side of zero. Now tell me, which situation is better? The loss of 2 rupees, which I represent as minus 2, or the profit of 4 rupees, which I represent as plus 4? Think again. Yes, getting 4 rupees is better than losing 2 rupees. So sad. So, we can say that getting 4 rupees makes me happier. And losing 2 rupees, which I represent as minus 2, makes me sad. Or in other words, if we talk mathematically, then 4 is greater than minus 2. Let's take another situation. This time, I lost 5 rupees and my friend lost 10 rupees. My situation or my friend's situation? I think I am at a better situation because I have lost only 5 rupees, which I represent as minus 5. My friend has lost more money, that is loss of 10 rupees, which I represent as minus 10. If I compare the state of happiness, then I am more happy than my friend. So my number is bigger than her number. So we can say that minus 5 is better or greater than minus 10. Now let's discuss some properties of integers. Commutative property of addition. Let's say I have 2 apples. Then I add 4 apples to it. How many apples do I have now? Yes, you're correct. They are 6 apples. Now let's see what happens if we reverse this order. We have 4 apples and then we get 2 more apples. How many apples do I have now? The answer is still 6. So we see 2 plus 4 is same as 4 plus 2, which is equals to 6. When we add first number to the second, or we add second number to the first, the answer in both cases remains the same. So, we can say that if A and B are 2 numbers, then A plus B is equal to B plus A. This is called commutative property of addition in whole numbers. Let's take another example, but this time with integers. If you get 2 rupees from your mother, you'll be happy. I will represent that by plus 2. And now when you go and check your bag and find that someone has stolen 4 rupees or they have been missing, now you become little sad. We represent that as minus 4. When you calculate the net result, we see that we are suffering the loss of 2 rupees, which we represent as minus 2. Now let's reverse this order in the story. You were checking your bag and you found that you have lost 4 rupees. So, now you became sad. We represent that as minus 4. And now, your mother gave 2 rupees to you. You are a little happy now. I will represent that by plus 2. What is the resultant effect? We see we are suffering the loss of 2 rupees, which we represent as minus 2. So, we see that 2 added to minus 4 is same as minus 4 added to 2, and the result is minus 2. So we can say that if A and B are 2 integers, then A plus B is equal to B plus A. This is called commutative property of addition in integers. Now answer this riddle. Can you think of a number which when added to the another number doesn't change the second number at all? Again, I'm giving you few seconds to think. Yes, you guessed it right. The number is 0. This 0 is called the additive identity. Remember that as this is one of the important concepts from examination point of view. We see that when we add 0 to 4 or 4 to 0, the answer is 4. Similarly, when we add minus 5 to 0 or 0 to minus 5, the answer is minus 5. Now think, which emotion smiley suits best for 0? The happy smiley? The sad smiley? Or a smiley with neutral emotion, which is neither happy nor sad? Yes, I think you are correct. The neutral smiley suits best. Now let's talk about another property of integers. Associative property of addition. Let's imagine you lost 5 rupees. Then somebody stole 10 rupees from your bag. And then later you lost another 20 rupees. So I repeat, you lost 5, then 10, and then 20 rupees. You must be very sad. Can you tell how much you lost in total? You can take a paper and a pen and write these numbers for your reference. First, add the loss of 5 and 10, which makes it 15. Then you can add loss of 20 more to it. So in total, we have a loss of 35 rupees, which we can write as minus 35. The other way can be that you add the loss of 20 to the loss of 10. What do we get? Loss of 30. And then add loss of 5 to it. So in total, we see that we have a loss of 35 rupees. So we also see that the result does not change even if we reverse or shuffle the order of these 3 numbers. So we see you lost 35 rupees, which we represent as minus 35. Hence, we see that if there are 3 integers A, B and C, then sum of A and B added to C will give the same result as A added to sum of B and C. This is called associative property of addition in integers. Now let's talk about closure property of addition. We saw that when we added 2 integers, the result was an integer. For example, minus 2 added to minus 4 gives minus 6. As we can see, minus 2 is an integer. Minus 4 is also an integer. And the result, minus 6, is also an integer. Since the result minus 6 is an integer, we can say that integer added to integer gives an integer. This is called closure property of addition. Let's take one more example. 2 added to minus 5 gives minus 3. Now is 2 an integer? Yes. Is minus 5 an integer? Yes. Is minus 3 an integer? Yes. Since all the 3 numbers are integers, so closure property holds true in addition. Now let's check whether you have understood the topic or not. Listen carefully and answer the following questions. Question 1. Which number is greater, माइनस फाइव और थ्री? आई रिपीट, विच नंबर इज ग्रेटर, माइनस फाइव और थ्री? बिफोर आंसरिंग जस्ट थिंक दैट बाय माइनस फाइव आई मीन लॉस ऑफ फाइव रुपीज एंड बाय थ्री वी मीन प्रॉफिट ऑफ थ्री रुपीज. सो विच सिचुएशन इज बेटर? Giving you few seconds to think and answer. Yes, I think you are correct. 3 is bigger than minus 5, as I would like to get 3 rupees instead of losing 5 rupees. Let's move on to second question. What should be added to minus 9 to get minus 9? I repeat, what should be added to minus 9 to get minus 9? Again, I'm giving you few seconds to think. Yes, I think you guessed it correct. The answer is 0. 0 added to any number doesn't make the difference at all. Now let's take another question. What should be added to 11 to get 0? I repeat, what should be added to 11 to get 0? Think and tell. Again, few seconds for that. Yes, you are correct. The answer is minus 11. Because if we add minus 11 to 11, we get 0. Now let's move on to question 4. Minus 5 added to minus 8 is equals to minus 8 added to which number? Listen carefully. I'm repeating the question. Minus 5 added to minus 8 is equal to minus 8 plus which number? Few seconds for that. I hope you're thinking right. The answer is minus 5, or you can say negative 5. Now question number 5. Listen carefully. Let's take a situation. In a quiz, plus 5 is given for correct answer and minus 1 is given for an incorrect answer. In that quiz, Ramesh gives 2 correct answers and 1 wrong answer. What would be the final score of Ramesh? I think I should repeat the question again. In a quiz, plus 5 is given for correct answer and minus 1 is given for an incorrect answer. In that quiz, Ramesh gives 2 correct answers and 1 wrong answer. What would be the final score of Ramesh? Think and give the answer. I'm waiting. If your answer is 9, then it is absolutely correct. You can give yourself a pat on the back. Now let's revise what we did today. We discussed about natural numbers. We also discussed that inclusion of 0 in natural numbers makes them whole numbers. We talked about integers today. And we discussed about the properties of addition in integers. The commutative property, which says that if a and b are two integers, then a plus b is equals to b plus a. The associative property, which says that if there are three integers a, b and c, then sum of a and b added to c will give the same result as a added to the sum of b and c. We also talked about additive identity. A number which added to another number doesn't change the second number at all. And we know that number is 0. Now let's once again check whether you have understood the topic or not. Listen carefully and answer the following questions. Question 1. Which number is greater, minus 7 or 10. I repeat, which number is greater, minus 7 or 10? Yes, I think this time you are correct. 10 is bigger than minus 7, as I would like to get 10 rupees rather than losing 7 rupees. Now question number 2. What should be added to minus 11 to get minus 11? I repeat, what should be added to minus 11 to get minus 11? Yes, you guessed it right. The answer is 0. 0 is the additive identity. Let's take another question. Question 3. What should be added to minus 7 to get 0? Think, what should be added to minus 7 to get 0? If your answer is 7, then the answer is correct. Because when we add positive 7 to negative 7, we get a 0. Now question 4. Minus 6 added to minus 8 is equals to minus 8 added to which number? Listen carefully. I repeat, minus 6 added to minus 8 is equal to minus 8 plus which number? I'm giving you few seconds to think and answer. Hope you are thinking right. The answer is negative 6, or we can say minus 6. Now question 5. Listen carefully and take a situation. Question 5 now. Listen carefully and take a situation. In a quiz, plus 5 is given for correct answer and minus 1 is given for an incorrect answer. In that quiz, Ram gives 2 correct answers and 3 wrong answers. What would be the final score of Ram? I repeat, in a quiz, plus 5 is given for correct answer and minus 1 is given for an incorrect answer. In that quiz, Ram gives 2 correct answers and 3 wrong answers. What would be the final score of Ram? Think and give the answer. I will give you some time to think. If your answer is 7, then it is correct. You can again give yourself a pat on the back. So, we did lots and lots of concepts today. We discussed about natural numbers. We discussed about the additive identity, which is 0. We talked about properties of addition of integers. We talked about commutative property and associative property. Now there is one activity for you. You can have playtime along with studying. You all must be having stairs in your house. You can stand on the middle stair. You can play this game with your friends too. If you say plus 2, then the person will move 2 steps down towards right. And if you say minus 2, then your friend will move 2 steps up. You can also ask your friends some complicated questions, some tricky questions. Like, you can give the command plus 2, minus 3. Let your friend think where he or she will land on the stairs. And this way, you can mark negative numbers, 0, and positive numbers on it. it is equivalent to a number line in maths. Let's discuss one more activity. When I say plus 3, you will do 3 claps with a smile. When I say minus 2, you will stomp your feet with a sad face. So let's play this game. Plus 3. Very good. I'll say minus 5. Hope you smiled when I said about positive integer and you were angry when I told you the negative integer. You will yourself feel which action gives you happiness. I feel we should always learn to be happy in spite of all the shortcomings we have in our life. When you understand a concept thoroughly, you feel happy for a long time. So keep on practicing and fulfill all your dreams. Thank you, students, for listening. You have been a wonderful audience. You are a great listener. And I feel that you are getting wiser and smarter. Hope you enjoyed learning through this session. I'm really hoping to meet you again. Bye-bye and always enjoy learning. Thank you.
So friends, you were just listening to the series Dhwani Shala.
Production assistants, Meenakshi Kukreti, Tanu Gupta and Jagbandhu Jana.
Recorded by Shanu Muksim and Vikas Sangwan.
This program was brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.